So this is Symyx Draw, which is the sort of new version of Isis Draw. So in this first part, we're just going to do a quick overview. And you can see here on the left-hand side, I've got the Tools menu, which is similar in many respects to the Tools menu in Isis Draw. We've got the Lasso tool for selecting, the Carbon-Carbon Bond tool for drawing carbon bonds, the Atom Label tool for changing the atom type, the Eraser, Arrow, and so on. This menu here is the Templates menu. So for example, if you want to draw commonly occurring components of organic structures, we can click on one of these and that'll draw that part, as we'll see later on. There's also a template directory. So we can see here are all of the templates that we can just draw straight away without having to draw the individual components. We just choose one of these and it'll draw the template for us. So to start off, what we want to do is just change the settings. And the reason is that if I draw, for example, a molecule, and I one of these to bromine, for example. You see, Symyx by default colours the atoms differently, so it gives the carbon a kind of a grey colour. Bromine, in this case, is a red colour. And really, when we're drawing structures, we want to have just black and white. So if I go into Options and Settings, you can see here all of the default options. There's quite a lot of options here, but I just want to change three for the moment. The first is color atoms by type, so I'm going to turn that off. Okay, now you see it's gone bold because that's not one of the default options now. We've changed it. For the moment, I want to change carbon show labeling, so I want to display carbon explicitly. That's on. Usually we don't have that on, but for the first few demonstrations, I just want to show that. And with that, I want to show hydrogens explicitly as well. Okay, so I click Apply and Save here. And now look what happens if I do the same thing again. If I draw my carbon-carbon structure with a bromine, we see that it's all black and white. Okay, so let's start off with drawing carbon-carbon bonds. So this is the carbon-carbon bond tool that we're familiar with in Isis Draw. So if I click on this, because I've chosen that I display my carbons and hydrogens explicitly, it's showing those. And if I just click on each carbon atom, it'll draw a chain. If I click on a carbon atom again, it'll draw a bridge off that chain. If I make a mistake, I can use the eraser tool. So for example, I didn't want that methyl to go up there. It'll just delete it. A very handy tool in Symyx Draw that I don't think was in Isis Draw is this chain tool. So if I click on this and just click and hold the mouse and drag it along for as many carbons as I want, it'll very quickly draw me an alkyl chain. There's a sub option to this. If I click on the blue button in the bottom right hand corner of this chain tool, that button there, and click, you see it draws an alkyl chain, but just a slightly different conformation. So that's a very quick an easy way of drawing chain tools or alkyl chains. Okay, so I'm just going to clean up my workspace a little bit here. I'll delete all of that using the lasso tool, and I'll delete this as well. And I'm just going to draw again a carbon-carbon chain. Maybe that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's heptane. Now, if I want to change one of these atoms so that it's a heteroatom, it's actually very easy to do in Symyx Draw. We can just use the lasso tool. There is an atom label tool here, but the lasso tool does exactly the same thing. Okay, so if we want to put an amino group onto in the position where the methyl is, I can just click on the methyl, type in N, and it'll automatically convert it to NH2. If I want to change the other end to, for example, a halogen like chlorine, I can just type in Cl, and it'll automatically change it to chlorine. Okay, so if we want to put in, for example, a carbonyl bond into this molecule, I'll draw in, say if I want to put in a carbonyl here, and I want this to be carboxylic acid. So the first thing I'll do is I'll change my NH2 to OH by just clicking on the lasso tool, clicking on the atom and typing it in. Now, if I hold my mouse over this carbon, you see I get a rectangle. In other words, I'm selecting that carbon. The same with this one. I'm selecting that carbon. If I can just about get in between the two, you can see here the mouse is now over the bond and a little rectangle around the bond. So in other words, when I choose the bond tool and I hold over that bond and click, it'll give me a double bond. Now sometimes it's very difficult to just get in between that space, so we can just zoom. So zoom in is F6, so I'll just press F6 a few times, and you can see now it's much easier to get in between there, and that'll give me a double bond. Now the last thing I want to do is change that CH2 to an oxygen, like that, and that gives me my carboxylic acid. Okay, I'm now going to move on to the templates, but before I do, I'm going to turn off my show carbons explicitly. So I'm going to go into Options, Settings, and turn off Display Carbons Explicitly. And then I'm going to change my hydrogen labels to just heteroatoms. In other words, I just want heteroatoms to show the hydrogens, for example, NH2. So, this is the benzene template, so if I click on that, it'll give me benzene. I can draw substituents using the bond tool or using the carbon-carbon chain. I can label these as before. So, for example, if I want to make a benzoic acid derivative, I can give myself a double bond here. Use the lasso tool just to change that to oxygen, that to OH, and there I have a benzoic acid derivative, or I could just get rid of this altogether, and that'll give me benzoic acid. So these templates are really useful for drawing structures very quickly that you might commonly come across. Benzene obviously is probably the most common one. So just delete that, and if I draw a molecule again, but this time I'm going to put in a stereo center. So I'm going to click on this guy twice. Now I need to make this a stereo center, so in other words I need to have four different substituents. So I'll click on this and make him bromine. Click on him and make him hydrogen. So now I've got four different substituents on this carbon here. A methyl group, an alkyl group, a hydrogen, and a bromine. If I now right click on this carbon, when I hold the mouse over the carbon, I get a square around it. If I right click, now it's just gone off the page. I'll just have to move that up a little bit so you can see it. So you can just see here, yeah, stereo configuration. And I hope it's just on your page there, set to or set to S. So for example, if you want that particular stereo configuration, it draws a dashed line. If you want the other one, it'll draw a wedge line. You can ask it to tell you what the stereo configuration of that carbon is by clicking on Show Stereo Configuration, and it'll put an S there. That'll be unusual. So I'll press Undo. Alternatively, if you don't want to say whether it's O or S, or you're not sure whether it is, you can just right-click on the bond and say that you want the bond to go up, to go down, or neither, or both. So if I click here, stereo bond, I want this to come up, then I've got one coming up, one going down. The last thing to cover in drawing molecules is things like radicals and ions and isotopes. And Symyx has a very nice feature. So for example, if I put in an O here, it'll automatically draw OH, but if I right-click on that and say charge, it'll allow me assign a charge to it. So I'll be able to say O minus. It's a very handy feature. If I have a carbon here and I wanted to say that was a particular isotope of carbon, I can choose the isotope. So I can choose its carbon 14, for example. If I wanted to have a radical, this is going to turn into a very unusual compound, but if I take this carbon here, right click and say radical, monoradical, it's a CH2 radical.